In the last tutorial, I introduced you to three types of lighting, one of which was specular lighting. Today, I'll show you how to improve specular lighting with the use of specular maps. I'll start by slightly modifying the texture class so that it's easier for us to assign multiple textures to the same shader. Then, I'll delete the pyramid we had and simply create a flat plane. I'll also import this wood texture and the specular map. You can find this in the description. I'll also assign the wood texture to the plane. Now, as you can see, the specular light is just sort of flat. Areas that shouldn't reflect much light, such as the cracks in the wood, still somewhat do so. And the areas that should reflect a lot of light, such as the smooth tops of the wood, don't really do so. In order to fix this, we can make use of something called a specular map. These types of maps are black and white textures that tell the program where specular light should appear and how strong it should be at that point. The whiter a pixel on the specular map is, the more specular light you'll get, and the blacker a pixel is, the less specular light you'll get. The idea is really simple. So to implement it, we must first import the specular map into our program. Make sure to import it using GLRED, not GLRGBA, since it only has one color channel, not four. Then simply export it to the shader and bind it in the main function. Now import the texture in the shader and in frag color, multiply its red value by the specular light and add that to the other texture, which is only multiplied by the diffuse and ambient lighting now. That's it for the specular light. Now I'll just change a value to make the light look better on the wood, and if you then boot up the program, you should see that the specular light looks much better and it makes the whole texture look better overall. As always, the source code is in the description. Bye!